And now, student, let's start the second part discussion on the chapter function.
That is types of function. Actually, we have different kinds of function. Number one, injective. Number two, surjective or onto. Both are same. Number three, bijective and into. Now, what are they? What are they? How to define? Injective. Injective says that distinct element in domain must have distinct image in codomain. Okay, distinct element in domain must have distinct image in codomain. What is surjective? Suppose for a function f a to b, f of a is equals to b. That means the range set will be exactly equal with the codomain set capital B. That will be the condition of surjectivity. What is bijective? If a mapping or function is injective as well as surjective, then the mapping will be known as the bijective mapping. And what is into? If the range set is a proper subset of the codomain set, is known as the into mapping. So these four types of mappings are there in our syllabus, in fact in abstract algebra also. The first one is injective, distinct element in domain must have distinct image. Surjectivity, range set and codomain set both are equal. Bijective, when the function or the mapping is both injective as well as surjective, then that will be treated as bijective. And what is into? Into is the range set is a proper subset of codomain set. Okay. So let me draw some figure to understand this thing. Okay, let us consider these six figures. These are much more important. This is the basic concept part. The first one, here in all the cases, the first set will be taken as A and the second set will be taken as B, A and B in all the cases. That means A is domain and B is codomain. Now look at the first figure. Here, what can be observed? We can observe in the domain set we have 5 elements. Now among these 5 elements, we can find the images of these 3 elements. These 3 elements has a pre as an image, as an image in the codomain set. Okay. But what about these 2 elements? These are the lone pair. We cannot find any image for these particular 2 elements. So can we say that this is a function? No, it is not a function, because all the elements of domain set hasn't used. That means it is not a function. Okay. Look at the second figure. What will happen here? If you observe the second figure, in the domain set we have 2 elements. Okay, good, fine. But what about the image of the first element? Do you find any uniqueness of images here? That means this element has mapped here also at that particular to distinct point in codomain set. Is it possible? No, it is not possible, because to be a function, the uniqueness of image must hold. Okay, so in that case also it is not a function. Look at the third figure. Here in the domain set we have 3 elements. You can observe we have 3 elements, and these 3 elements has mapped into the codomain set. Very good. Look at the correspondence. Here we can say the distinct elements in domain set has a pre-image, has an image in codomain set. Distinct image, distinct element, distinct image. So injective, try to remember the definition of injective function. In that case, can we say it is an injective function? Yes, it is an injective function, but it is not a surjective function. Why? Because for surjective function we cannot find any unused element in the codomain set. But here in codomain set we have 4 unused elements. That's why this function is injective but not surjective. Okay, look at this figure. Here, do you think this function is injective? It is a function, obviously. It is a function because all the elements of domain has used and images are unique. Now the question is, what is the nature of this function? Do you think it is injective? No, it is not injective, because two distinct element in domain has the common image. So it is not injective. Is it surjective? Yes, it is surjective, because in the codomain set we cannot find any unused element. Like this. So it is a function, like it is surjective but not injective. Okay. Now look at this figure. Here it is a function, obviously it is a function, all the elements of domain has used and uniqueness of the image hold good. Now which kind of function it is, which kind of mapping it is? Do you think it is injective function? No, it is not injective, because for these two elements, two distinct element in domain has a common image. So it is not injective. Is it surjective? It is not also surjective, because in the codomain set you can find unused element. So it is not injective and not surjective. Not injective plus not surjective. Look at the last figure. Here, obviously it is a mapping. No doubt about it. Now, is it injective? Yes, it is injective. Because distinct element in domain has distinct image in codomain. Injective. Surjective. It is also surjective. It is also surjective. Because you cannot find any unused element in codomain. You cannot find any unused element in codomain. So it is injective as well as surjective. And we know when a function is injective as well as surjective, it is known as bijective function. Got it? Now, this part has also discussed types of function. Now, we will go for the fifth part. Analytical method to detect the nature of function. Analytical method. That was discussed by pictorial diagram, that how to detect a function, the nature of the function, whether it is injective or surjective or bijective, that can be decided. But what is the analytical method to describe the nature of the function? The first thing is injective. There is some particular working rule for injectivity. For injectivity, in step one, we have to start from here. Let fx1 equals to fx2 for some x1 comma x2 belongs to the domain of the function. Okay. If we can show that x1 equals to x2, then f is injective. Okay. Another way is there to detect injectivity. We can start from here, x1 not equals to x2. Let x1 not equals to x2. Then if somehow we can show that fx1 is not equals to fx2, then also we can claim f is injective. Okay, so this is a way to show the injectivity. Next, we will discuss about the way to show surjectivity. It is very important. For this part, we have to start from here. Let y belongs to codomain be any arbitrary element, okay, such that y equals to fx for some x belongs to domain. After that, express x as a function of y. After that, express x as a function of y from here. Then observation. Number one, if there exists at least one element y belongs to codomain such that x in domain doesn't exist. That means if you find any element y in codomain so that the x is not defined, the preimage of y is not defined. So, in that case, then f is not surjective. Observation 2, if for all, this sign means for all, If for all y belongs to codomain, there exists at least one x belongs to domain, then f is surjective. Okay? So this is the working rule of surjectivity. Surjectivity is very much important. At first you have to take an element y from codomain set, arbitrarily chosen. After that, you have to express x in terms of y. Then you have to observe whether there exists a y. If you find at least one y in codomain set so that you cannot find the preimage of this particular element y in the domain set, then you will conclude that f is not surjective. But if you can ensure, that for all y, that is for all members of codomain set, we can find at least one preimage in domain set, we can conclude that f is surjective. So let us take some example that will clear the thing. Let f such that S to R, S is a particular set defined as fx equals to x by 1 minus mod x, where S is open interval minus 1 to 1. Okay. Now we have to check whether this function is injective or surjective, whatever the nature. So we will start from here. At first, we have to remove the modulus. So let x be greater than equals to 0. This is your domain. So naturally, x belongs to this one, as x is greater than equals to 0 and this is your domain. So x will lie between this particular region. So in that case, fx, that is y, is equals to x by 1 minus x, because we know mod x equals to x when x greater than equals to 0, and it is equals to minus x when x is less than 0. Now the question is, this function is injective or not? So let x1 comma x2 belongs to S be any two elements such that fx1 equals to fx2. The working rule, try to remember the working rule, fx1 equals to fx2. So it is x1 by 1 minus x1 equals to x2 by 1 minus x2. Obviously, x1 and x2 is not equals to 1. X1 and x2 is not equals to 1 because x belongs to semi-closed interval 0 to 1. 1 is not included here. So that will be defined. Now go for the cross multiplication. X1 minus x1 x2 equals to x2 minus x1 x2. Minus x1 x2 x2 cancel. That is x1 equals to x2. So ultimately what we find? Ultimately we find fx1 equals to fx2 will implies x1 equals to fx2, x1 equals to x2. So what will be our conclusion? Naturally, our conclusion will be f is injective. So what about surjectivity in this particular case? What will be the surjectivity? Let y belongs to R, because codomain is R. Y belongs to R be any arbitrary element such that y equals to fx for some x belongs to S. That is, y equals to fx. Fx is x by 1 minus x. So here, y minus xy equals to x, that is x into 1 plus y equals to y, okay, xy plus x into 1 plus y equals to y. So x equals to y by 1 plus y, okay, is that clear? Now what can be said about this function? Do you think if you take any y, if you take any y from this codomain set, do you think you can find all the all the images of x? The answer is, if you take y equals to minus 1, then what will happen? If you take y equals to minus 1, then what will happen? In that case, we can say that the pre-image of minus 1 doesn't exist in domain. That's why it is not surjective. It is not surjective. Okay, this function is injective but not surjective. Got it? Now, the last part of our discussion is graphical approach to detect the nature of the function. We have a technique. What is the technique? If every horizontal line, intersects the graph of the function, number one, at most once, then it is injective. At least once, then it is surjective. And number three, exactly once, then it is bijective. Now let me explain with some example. Now this is the graph of sin x, y equals to sin x. Okay, we all know the domain of this function. It is a real number. The domain is real number, and codomain, C for codomain, D for domain. Codomain or range. Range is closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Now, If you take this horizontal line, then it will cut the graph so many points, So can we say that it is injective? Because to be injective, the graph should be cut by the horizontal line at most once, maximum one time it will cut, but here it will cut in several times, so it is not injective. Do you think it is surjective? Okay, let us take this horizontal line which is above 1 actually, this is 0, 1, which is above 1 in y axis. So this particular horizontal line will not cut the graph of the function at least once it will not cut. So it is not surjective. as it is not surjective, as it is not surjective as well as injective, it will not a bijective function. Okay, let us take another example. Suppose this is the graph of y cos to a to the power x when a is greater than 1. Okay, we know the domain of this function. The domain of this function is R, that is whole real number. And what about the range of this function? The range of this function is always positive. This one. This function is injective. Okay, let us check whether it is injective or not. This one, horizontal line, cut at most once the graph, at most one, this point, it will not cut in several points of the graph. So, do you think it is injective? Yes, it is injective. Okay, now if this function a to the power x is R to this one, R to this one, then that is codomain is 0, comma, that is codomain is 0, comma infinity. So, here if you take any horizontal line, it will cut exactly once. But if we take any horizontal line here, it will not cut the graph. That means if we take the codomain as real number, this is not surjective. But if we take the codomain as 0, comma infinity, then we can conclude that it will cut the graph exactly once. That's why it will be known as the bijective function. Got it? The last example for today. This is the graph of y cos to mod x. What do you think? You know the domain. The domain is real number and range is positive real number. Okay, you know that, the domain and range. Now, do you think it is injective? Okay, let us check. Let us take any horizontal line. It will cut the graph at two points. So, at most once it will intersect. It will not happen. So, it is not injective. Do you think it is surjective? If we take the codomain, again, I am talking about the codomain. If we take the codomain as real number set, then we can find horizontal line which will not intersect the graph of the curve. In that case, it is not surjective. But if we take the codomain as this one, then all the lines will intersect two times. So, it is not surjective. It is not surjective if we take this one. That is, if we take the codomain as real number, it will not surjective. But if we take the codomain as semi-closed interval 0 to infinity, then it will be surjective. Because it will cut the graph at least once. Got it? So, that's all for today. In our next class, we will discuss about the composition of function and rest of the things. That's all. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Leave a like and comment. Subscribe. And do share the video among your friends.